Conservatively, what percentage of our platform is porn? 9%? 90?
This motherfucker don't miss.
No, he's fucking good.
That motherfucker don't miss, man.
He's good.
In the heat of battle, he don't miss.
No.
In the heat of controversy, he don't.
Tchaikovsky, cannons are not instruments.
Yes, they are, and I'm going to use 21 of them.
Tchaikovsky, no.
Tchaikovsky, yes. Tchaikovsky, always yes!
If you want a cool new magic item with a lot of storytelling potential, give your players a mysterious key that can unlock any door. Now, it makes sense that an item this powerful might have a drawback or some kind of curse, right? Well, while I did say that this key could unlock any door, I didn't say where or what would be on the other side if you use it. Your players just might be opening a portal into another world. Or they might be unleashing that monster they've been hearing stories about. Happy adventuring!
Who's the plunger?
I'm afraid I left the house without my plunger tonight, Orla.
I made two nightmares out of us.
Can't stop the spirits when they need you. Dee-ba-da-ba-da-dee-na-dee-doo.
What if everything in a dungeon was a mimic, except for all the doors and chests?
That taco place you love so much?
No, Gurr loves that place. I think it's dirty.
I ate a baby there.
He did.
Tell me you're a bisexual without telling me you're bisexual.
What?
This is the fourth time this week you've all been rude to our dear, dear quartermaster. Do you think he likes being suspended from the ceiling against his will?
Do not speak for my interests.
Maybe depressed, but at least I have an iced coffee.
You're still depressed.
But I have an iced coffee.
But you're still depressed.
Okay, but I have an iced coffee.
It's been a while since I've seen the young hobbit.
Gandalf!
What's the best armor for stealth in D&D? Hide! Just kidding, it's actually full plate. Full plate armor is generally regarded as one of the worst armors for stealth because you have disadvantage on stealth checks. But the thing is that hiding doesn't always have to be about stealth, or at least not the actual stealth skill. You see, in fantasy times, it was fairly common to have full suits of armor just standing around places. If you have full plate with the visor and everything, you can potentially hide by just standing there. Of course, you'd have to do this in a place that makes sense, like a castle or a dungeon, but it could potentially work, allowing you to hide in a place that nobody else can. And at least for me, I would definitely rule this as more of a deception or a performance check rather than a stealth check.
Screw it. Perpendicular dice stacking.
What the hell?
This dude divided by zero and just broke physics. So now what? We live in a world with tall gnomes. Dragons who don't like hoarding things. Rogues with happy living parents. You get the...
Welcome to Quincy's Tavern, my friends. What can I get for you? Well, we have anything you could possibly need. We have potions, weapons, magical artifacts, maps to places you need to go. What do you need? Not sure. Well, that's a new one. Everyone seems to know what they want when they come here. I think I know just the person who could possibly help you.
Hello, adventurers. I've seen many adventures over my eons of time, but I hear that you are having trouble figuring out what it is you want. My skill set is to help those who can't put to words what their truest desires are, bring them to reality. So tell me, my friends, what is it you truly desire? Interesting, this is a rare object, but I believe I can do this within 24 hours' time. Now, tell me, what is it you're willing to pay for this deal? Alright, make yourself comfortable. I'll see you back in a day.
You know what? There are times in life where you have to just sit back and go, all right, you know what? I'm proud of myself. Yeah. Is this one of those times? No.
Okay. Okay, I'll be right back. Oh, no. Okay. Just hang tight for me, all right? I'm going to grab some water and a blanket. Just... This is a sending stone to my parole officer. Let them know I'm gonna need a bailout. No. I saw who you came in with. That's a buzzkill. I am here, though. Let's talk it out.
I'm here as a translator. I can speak the same language as some of the people we'll meet along the way. So I could help Lewis and Clark talk to them.
A real-life translator? You do what my hoodie does.
You're not gonna kill me.
Oh, yeah, I killed my dad and my sister, but I could never kill my husband fucking best friend.
Am I really your best friend? You're not just saying that for, you know.
No, I'm not just saying that at all.
I get worried that it's just me.
I know, sometimes I was worried about that too.
Sending your players to a pumpkin patch can be a great and relaxing Halloween one-shot. Until your players realize that that house in the middle of the field is actually a giant pumpkin lich, controlling all of those pumpkin-headed skeletons now rising from the ground.
D&D Squid Game. Build a dice tower in 30 seconds without it falling over. Ready? Go! Player 1920, pass.
Oh my god.
Could you let me see?
Come on!
Oh god!
I gave you a lace parasol!
She is just...
A tea set!
Not that into you.
A bracelet!
Gotta take that hint, bro.
I am in love with you!
You gotta let it go.
I wanna put my face between your boobs!
Welcome to Quincy's Tavern, my friend. What can I get for you? Looking to hire an adventurer? Well, we have many here. Is there anything in particular? What's the quest? I think I know just the hero. Ask an or.
Is there a problem?
Oh, no problem. This adventurer needs some help, and I think you have the perfect skill sets for it.
My name is Eskinor, the Lion Sin of Pride, and I would be honored to join you on your quest.
Very well then. It's settled. I'll get everything together. Be safe out there.
No one ever gets to me.
I did.
You've come the closest. Now you're in my way.
Thank you.
Didn't mean it as a compliment.
Yes, you did.
Yeah, okay, I did. But the flirting's over, Sherlock. Daddy's had enough now.
So D&D TikTok, stitch this and show me your I'm playing D&D tonight looks.
I have a couple, and they will go from cute to terrible in that progression. First is if I have a chance to play in person, where I will put on human people clothes and look presentable with like full face of makeup. Though these days, I mostly play online, which entails a baggy shirt, some gym shorts, and on occasion I'll put some eyeliner on, just to, you know, schnazz it up. There are rare occasions where I feel like garbage, but I'm not gonna miss this game unless I'm in the hospital, so I don the cranky sprout hair, the angst cocoon, and I just hunker down and I muscle through it, you know? Though sometimes I just do this because I'm comfy and warm, and I play downstairs where it's very cold, so sometimes it's a necessity. Okay, bye!
Let me show you what you're missing. Paradise. Okay. So this person just stitched my video and said they stacked 14 dice and that they are challenging me, and I have to accept this now.
The most I dared try was 17. Oh, and I'll prove they're, not super glued that time.
Let's talk about the difference between chaotic neutral and chaotic stupid. Now, chaotic neutral is one of the more controversial alignments I feel like a player can choose. Because in my experience, it's one of the most fundamentally misunderstood alignments. Mostly by new players, and absolutely by problem players. They view it as an excuse to be able to do anything without any reason. Because they're chaotic neutral. Here's a classic example. Okay, you enter a village. What do I find? Well, there's a lot of local businesses, taverns, shops, anything else? Yeah, there's a local orphanage. Oh, great, I burn it down. What? Why? Well, that's what my character would do. In what world would your character just burn down an orphanage for no reason? Chaotic neutral. The way that I've always viewed chaotic neutral is that, yes, they are indeed impulsive, but they're not psychotic. Wish for a grilled cheese, don't punch the king.
Nobody's gonna know. Nobody's gonna know.
They're gonna know. How would they know? How would they know? How would they know?
I can't. I just, I can't.
Oh my god!